This video presentation is the pre-lab discussion for the fourth experiment, determination of an equilibrium constant. In this experiment, we'll find ourselves using the technique of spectrophotometry to determine the equilibrium constant for the formation of the thiocyanatoiron 3 coordination complex. This particular complex ion is formed from an aqueous solution of iron 3 with the addition of thiocyanate. The aqueous solution of iron 3 will consist of the hexa-aqua iron 3 complex ion, which, upon addition of thiocyanate, leads to the formation of penta-aqua thiocyanatoiron 3, an orange-red complex. This chemical equation, of course, has been on the complex side, and so it's not uncommon to see our cells simplifying matters by excluding water. That is, we can write this particular equilibrium system as simply being the reaction between iron 3 and thiocyanate to form what we could call the iron thiocyanate complex, where the equilibrium constant K is equal to the equilibrium concentrations of the iron thiocyanate complex divided by the concentrations of the iron 3 and thiocyanate also at equilibrium. The thiocyanatoiron 3 complex ion absorbs in the blue-green region of the visible spectrum at a wavelength of about 447 nanometers. We take advantage of this absorption by making use of the Beer-Lambert law. That is, the equilibrium concentrations of the complex can be determined through the use of a Beer-Lambert plot. And, given knowledge of the initial concentrations and this final equilibrium concentration, it becomes possible to also calculate the equilibrium concentrations of the reactants through the use of an ice table. Given knowledge of the equilibrium concentrations of all the species in this system, it then becomes possible to determine the equilibrium constant. Good times, eh? So, for the experimental method, there'll be two parts of this experiment. In the first part of the experiment, an excess amount of iron 3 will be mixed with different amounts of the thiocyanate ion. The excess amount of iron 3 will drive the reaction to near completion. We might consider run number 1 as an example, where the initial concentration of iron 3 at 0.04 molar is 2,000 times greater than the concentration of thiocyanate at 2 times 10 to the minus 5 molarity. The incredibly large concentration of iron relative to thiocyanate drives this reaction to completion, as expected by Le Chatelier's, such that we have an equilibrium concentration of the iron thiocyanate complex that's equivalent to the concentration of thiocyanate to begin with. If one knows the initial concentration of thiocyanate, then one will also know the final equilibrium concentration of the thiocyanatoiron 3 complex ion. Knowing the final concentration of that complex ion allows us to measure an absorbance and, of course, determine from that, or rather produce from that, a Beer-Lambert blot. And this, of course, is the inherent task in part 1 of the experiment, to produce the Beer-Lambert plot from known concentrations of the complex. With that Beer-Lambert plot produced, we then turn our attention to the second part of the experiment, where the concentrations of the iron 3 and the thiocyanate ions will be similar. Given the similar concentrations, we expect this particular system to stop far short of completion, but rather reach equilibrium. Here, as an example, we have run number 6, where the concentrations of the iron 3 and the thiocyanate are very similar, both on the order of millimolar concentrations. Given the change will be far less than complete, we represent it with a variable x, and write from that change an initial and equilibrium line. Given, of course, the fact that we're measuring the absorbance of the iron thiocyanate complex, we'll know its concentration at equilibrium. That concentration, taken from the absorbance measurement, will represent x. And with x known, it becomes possible at that point to calculate the value of the equilibrium constant. In regards to the experiment, You will be working with two other classmates to clean and condition three 50 milliliter burettes. Each person will clean, condition, and fill a burette with one of the following solutions: a 1 times 10 to the minus 3 molar potassium thiocyanate solution, a 0.2 molar iron 3 nitrate solution, or a 0.5 molar nitric acid solution. From that point forward, you will work individually to prepare and measure the absorbance of each solution. In part one of the experiment, you'll produce 5 standard solutions, which will then be used to prepare the Beer-Lambert plot. The 5 standards will have their absorbances measured using the LabQuest 2 and SpectraVis probe, using, of course, procedures as have been seen in previous experiments. After part one, it all gets kind of crazy. In part two of the experiment, you'll find yourself preparing 2 solutions: a 2 times 10 to the minus 4 molar solution of potassium thiocyanate in a 250 ml beaker, and separate from this, a solution of 0.1 molar iron 3 nitrate. You'll then find yourself pipetting 1 milliliter of the 0.1 molar iron 3 nitrate into the beaker containing the 2 times 10 to the minus 4 molar potassium thiocyanate. You'll then gently mix the solution through swirling. You'll fill a cuvette of the solution and then measure its absorbance using the SpectraVis probe. Upon measuring the absorbance, you'll pour the solution from that cuvette back into the beaker with your mixture. You'll then pipette another 1 milliliter aliquot of the 0.1 molar iron 3 nitrate into the beaker and repeat the process of swirling, filling a cuvette, measuring its absorbance, and pouring it back into the beaker. In fact, this process will be repeated until you've added a total of 5 milliliters of the 0.1 molar iron 3 nitrate into the 250 ml beaker. And of course, a total of 5 absorbance measurements have been recorded. Here is an image of what the data tables are likely to appear like. The first data table from part one, which has runs 1 through 5, will involve recording the absorbance values. The data table in part two, runs 6 through 10, will involve measurements of the absorbance, the different solutions produced upon the addition of the iron 3 nitrate.